Hello everyone, my name is Remy Dayan. I'm a senior technical specialist on the Power Platform. In this video, we're going to explore how we can connect Copilot Studio to a Dataverse table and use its content to find information using natural language. For this demo, I'm using a trial for Copilot Studio, which includes full Dataverse access. My demo tenant also comes with AI Builder credits that I will be able to use in my scenario to call a GPT custom prompt. The use case I'm going to walk you through is to allow users to query structured data sitting in Dataverse by using Copilot Studio. For this example, I'm using a fake hotel chain, which offers timeshare properties that you can reserve using points. The first thing I did was to create a new Dataverse table to store the information I wanted to leverage in my Copilot. To this scenario, I want to build an assistant that can help me find the perfect trip destination for my next vacation. So I created a table that contained destination name, description, activities, cost in points, start date, end date, number of bedroom, etc. The list of criteria really depends on how you want to approach your use case. I also created a user info table, which I will use to store the user profile and point balance. Points can be used to purchase trip and will be a key information that I will use to filter the list of potential destination. You could imagine having a more complex data model with other information that we could leverage in our search, like trip preferences, past trips, etc. Once I've created my data model, I can create a new AI builder prompt that will be key to retrieve the data based on the user input. Typically, travel website will allow you to search via drop-down or a catalog. I want something that is more flexible for my users. First thing I'm going to do is open Copilot Studio and create a topic to find my destination. When I want to trigger that topic, I want to make sure my user is logged in because I need to be able to know who that user is, and I want to be able to retrieve the point balance from that particular user. In my topic, I have two options. I can either ask question to the user to understand what kind of trip the user wants to make, or I can describe the trip, and the large language model will use that description to find relevant information. Here I'm calling a Power Automate flow to retrieve the user balance before I'm able to query the actual list of trip. Once I've gathered information regarding the trip, like the description of the trip, I can create a new Power Automate flow by clicking plus, call an action, and then create a new flow. Creating a new flow will open Power Automate with the Power Virtual Agent trigger here. I'm going to add two inputs for that flow. The first is the trip description that the user will send from Copilot Studio. And the second is the point balance that is retrieved via another Power Automate flow that calls an API once the user is authenticated. Now it's time to call my AI Builder prompt. Here, I can add an action, go on AI Builder, and in here, I'm going to use create text with GPT using a prompt. That prompt will take also two parameters in, the point balance and the trip description coming from my Power Virtual Agent or Copilot trigger. I'm going to click edit, and this is where I need to build my prompt. And this is what is going to be key for this scenario. The first thing I'm going to do is add data. So here I selected my table that contains the list of trip. And you notice that I can also filter that table because some trips may not be available. So here I have the list of columns available. And within that trip, I have a flag that says, is this trip available, yes or no? So I'm going to filter on available trip only. That's the data I'm going to use. Then you can see my two input parameters, the trip description and the point balance. You can provide sample data for each input parameters that allows you to test your prompt very quickly once your prompt is ready. Now let's talk about how we are going to use a prompt and what makes a great prompt. At the beginning, I'm focusing on describing the persona of that AI, to that AI model. I want a polite and cheerful travel agent expert that is helping user to book its next vacation. I don't want to repeat any of the parameter like the trip description or the destination. I want the model to use planner vocabulary that can inspire travelers. I also want the model to use emoji to illustrate each destination. And I want to iron a line break after each destination suggestion. Now comes the interesting part. I'm going to ask my model to find the best possible trip based on the user description, which is what is going to be sent to Copilot Studio. And then I add some custom instruction regarding the logic I want the model to take when approaching the prompt and approaching the data I'm going to send. For example, I do not want to suggest any other destination if I find one available in the trip list, but maybe I want to suggest other destination if I don't find a match, because I want my model to be a little bit smart. And instead of saying, I don't have an option for you, maybe suggest something that is similar. So if you don't find a good match, I want to suggest similar dates within the same point range, within the same activities and bedroom numbers, because when you travel with a certain number of people, you want to make sure that everyone fits in that bedroom. I also tell the model that I want to check the point balance and it has to be more than the trip cost. And in here, I can inject the data from my Dataverse table. I can click plus, I can click on my table, and in here, I can look at my column, the cost in point. So I'm giving, fine-tuning the model by giving hints on the tables and columns to be checked during the process. If the point balance is not enough, please suggest alternative with similar dates, points, activities. Mention that in this case, they can either buy or borrow more points. That's very common in the timeshare industry. Users have a yearly point balance and they can buy or borrow additional points. Then I want to make sure that we have enough bedroom. If not, then suggest a destination with a higher number of bedroom. I want to make sure my model gives a nice description to the trip, mention the start date, end date, the number of bedroom, the cost. If you don't find a magic destination or a good alternative, we are in the last resort, say you're sorry and ask the user to try a different option. Because we want to give an alternative to the model when the model cannot find any data, any matching data in our data source. I also instruct my model to make sure to provide a link to each destination by embedding the corresponding URL using a specific format. That's the format that Copilot Studio will recognize and will be showing as a hyperlink in my Copilot. And at the bottom, I also provide some specific instruction or specific information regarding my trip list. I'm inserting some of the columns from my trip vacation to build a trip list, because during my prompt, I'm referring the available match in the trip list. Once I've created my prompt, I can put sample data for the point balance and the trip description, and I can test it. There you go. I'm asking to go to Orlando for my next trip. And I do have Orlando as a destination in my table. And I can see that the prompt found the right information, wrote a description for this trip, gave me the start date and end date, just like I asked, the number of bedroom, the cost. It generated the link with the specific format I instructed and a quick summary of what that trip will look like. It also says that the cost trip is 1,200 points, which is within my point balance of 2,000 points. If I'm interested in that trip, I can book right away. So I'm acting as a travel agent. I'm going to save that custom prompt and switch back to Copilot Studio. We are now back to Copilot Studio. You can see that I added my Power Automate flow here with my trip description that is coming from my topic, and the point balance that I retrieve when the user authenticates on my Copilot. Let's go ahead and publish that Copilot, and we're going to test it. Here, I'm on the demo website of Copilot Studio. You can see my Copilot just popped up, and I'm going to log in to pretend I'm authenticated on my Copilot. The Copilot recognizes my user and greets me with my name. Hello, Remy. Thank you for being a valued customer. And now I have some quick reply where I can check my point balance or find destination. Let's try point balance. Here, I'm calling the point balance flow that will retrieve my point balance for this particular user from another Dataverse table. Here, my point balance is 2,000 points. Since I'm requesting my point balance, the Copilot suggests, would you like me to book your next vacation? Which is the natural flow once you check your balance. I say yes. I designed my Copilot to have two options. Either my Copilot will ask me a question or I can just describe my trip. Let's go with describe the trip. The first trip I want to try and find is a visit in Paris in June or October. So I'm giving a wide list of options for my Copilot. I want to go to a place and I'm giving two time slots, time period for my Copilot. So here, my Copilot found a couple of trips. First one, Paris in October, it gives me a description, the date match, the October request from October 12 to October 26, number of bedroom one, cost of point 1,000. I can click here and it takes me to the website I added in my data source, the Paris travel website. And also, I also have another option in June. Different dates, different number of bedroom, slightly more expensive because there are two bedrooms. And also gives me a link to my trip. And it also tells me that both of these trips are within my point balance. So if I'm interested, I can either go ahead and book that trip either by contacting the website or calling a phone number. At the end, I'm asking my user, do you want to look for other options so that it's a little bit easier if the user wants to iterate and try to find other possibilities? Yes, please. Let's go and try to suggest two places and ask for a specific number of bedrooms. Again, the Copilot found couple of destinations. The first one is Hawaii. It's in my list. It's in June. It has two bedrooms, but it costs 3,000 points. And you can see that the Copilot understood that it has to check the number of points. And it says the cost of this trip exceeds your current balance. However, I do have another alternative for you. It's Bali. It was also on my list. It only has one bedroom and it's 3,000 points. Let's take a look at another option. Here, I'm going to ask a very specific question to my Copilot to see if it can find the right trip. I want to go skiing with my family in Park City for a specific set of dates, and I need four bedrooms. I do have a listing in my database for that particular city and those particular dates. However, this listing is not available. Since I instructed my Copilot to find similar trips within the same date range and same properties, it found another trip, another potential destination in the Swiss Alps that is also four bedroom, that is also during the same period of time, and that cost 2,500 points. Again, it tells me that I don't have enough points. I can either buy or borrow more points to cover the cost. So here we go. We had three different searches. Some are quite vague, some are very precise, and we can see that AI Builder grounded on the Dataverse table is able to find accurately information relevant to the user. That's it for today. Thanks for watching.